Good morning, everyone. Welcome to my second episode of How to Get Your Delphi Application into the Microsoft Store. Today, we will look into some more details about things that you need to do in addition to what I've already shown in my first video. As always, if you have any questions, just send me an email at olaf@monian.net. All right, the details we are going to talk about today is how to actually target more than just one platform. So on Windows, we of course have 32 and 64-bit, and your application or your store submission can actually target both platforms. I'm going to show how to do that. And versioning is something you have to be careful about. In Windows, there are actually four fields to version your executables. For the Microsoft Store, you can actually only use the first three fields. So it's version 1.2.3 or something, but the last field needs to be zero. Otherwise, Microsoft actually rejects your binary if the field is different from zero. And important, if you supply your own privacy policy by entering a privacy policy URL, make sure that the URL is correct, of course, and that the content on that page is actually a real privacy policy. I got actually a late rejection, or actually just a warning, that my privacy policy was not really a privacy policy, but just terms of use, because I had actually a URL pointing to the terms and not to the privacy policy. So there are humans, obviously, looking at what you are submitting here. So let's see how all this works, and let's go to Delphi. All right, so this is Delphi 10.3 again. It's the same hash expert application that I used with my first video. I did some minor enhancements visually, and I'm going to try an updated submission to the Microsoft Store. And this submission, in contrast to the first one I did, which was 32 bits only, will target 32 bits and 64 bit. Technically, if we weren't on Delphi, we could even target mobile phones. We could target Xboxes and stuff like that. Each of those platforms can have their own executables. The way it would work is pretty much the same as when we are going to supply just 32-bit executables and 64-bit executables for desktop Windows. All right, so the first thing is we worked in Windows 32-bit, which is here, and you have the configuration application store. So basically, to get started to supply your stuff, go to the project settings, and in the project settings, make sure, oops, something's wrong with my logos. Not a problem. I actually changed the file name here. So, well, I get tons of error messages, not a big problem. So let's fix those things first. So we are going to application icons and then into the logos settings. And as always in the settings, make sure you apply the settings to the right configuration. So we are going to release in release configuration, of course. Don't use debug for releasing into the Microsoft Store. You don't want to have all the debug stuff in your application. It would make your executable file larger, and it will contain things that Microsoft might get concerned about. So make sure we are in release, and we have to go into release configuration Windows 32-bit first. And there, of course, the error messages are again, load the logo. And the logos are actually here. The first one is the larger one. Okay, that's this one. And this is the 44 logo. Let's load that one. Okay, So this is fine. And make sure the same thing, the same settings are in the other platform, Windows 64-bit. There is no way to specify that in the single place. It's just not possible. So it's nasty, it's tedious, you have to do that. So let's make sure we have the correct file selected here. Load logo again, and here we are. And now that should be good. The next thing is version information. That's what I talked about. So the first version I had was version 1.0. So this version is going to be 1.0.1, and that's fine for a Microsoft Store. Don't use the build number. That won't work. Microsoft rejects anything else than zero in here. Okay, so product version is still 1.0, and the file version is going to be 1.0.1. And that's this number is what's going into the manifest file, which is important for the store submission. And again, this is now for Windows 64-bit release configuration, all right? And make sure the same thing is again on the other platform, 32-bit. So 1.0 and 1.0.1.0 up here. Okay, let's save that. And before we save, actually, let's go to the provisioning. So deployment, provisioning. Make sure everything is correct here as well for all the platforms again. So this is 32-bit release, and we are going to build for the application store. Make sure you select store. And here, this is the package name, hash expert. This is my publisher ID. You don't need to make a copy of those. It's actually only useful for my account. So, and that is this one. And also make sure this is the same for the 64-bit version. So store, everything should be exactly the same here. Sometimes when building the application, or actually deploying the application to build the APPX file, it might come up with a weird error message that there is something missing, that the project name is wrong or something. Just go back into this settings dialog in the provisioning dialog and just look at it and save again. That seems to fix these error messages that might pop up from time to time. All right, so we configured everything in the right way. So we have 32-bit application store. Now do a full build. Full build is actually done. I always do that by hitting the shortcut. So I have to look where it is here. I never do that here. So build all projects, okay. That's doing a full build, okay. And now we have an executable in the normal build output directory that you can configure on the project settings page. So the next step is to deploy. Deploy means actually build the APPX file that we are going to supply to Microsoft. So that's done. That's 32-bit. Now let's go to the 64-bit configuration application store. And again, do a full build. Here we go. It's compiling, it's building everything. Okay, and second step, deploy it. Okay, so we actually should have two APPX files now, and let's have a look where they are. So let's go to the project directory. Here we go. And these are my output directories. So let's go to the Win32 one, which is here. So this is the normal result when it compiles your application. That's the application that you just can run on your own system. Then when we hit the deploy button down here, when we hit this deploy thing, this one here, then it actually creates this subdirectory. And in this subdirectory, we have, in the bin subdirectory, we have the APPX file. Okay, let's move that one to the desktop. Okay, And let's go to the 64 bits one. And same thing here. And of course we have to rename it so that we have two different files. Move it to the desktop again. And let's go to the desktop. And we have two files. And let's rename that one to 32-bit. Okay, so the next thing is now to actually bring those two files into the App Store. I'm gonna show you that the next minute. All right, so I'm already in Microsoft's Partner Center, which is the place where you basically prepare your submissions to the Microsoft Store. So we are already in the product section of my account, where I only have one product for now, which is the Hash Expert. And in the application overview, we see the actual first submission that I did with the first video. And here I already created a new second submission. So if you have just one which is already in the store, then there would be a button that allows you to add a new submission. Okay, let's go into the submission that I just created. And if you create a new submission, it will just copy the first one. So you don't have to re-enter every and each value. So you only change those parts that you really need to change. And like I mentioned before, what I did wrong, or where I had a minor error in it, was in the properties section. And there you have the chance to enter your own privacy policy URL. And here, make sure that this URL is really correct and leads to a valid document. There is somebody reading all this stuff. Okay, so let's go back to the submissions. And now go to this, to the packages. This is basically the only thing that gets changed. I already removed the old package. They just copied the submission entries into a new one that you can edit. So I removed the old one. I don't want to basically resubmit my original one, and just you could actually do that and just change like URLs or something. I removed that. So here we can actually now browse for our APPX files that we just created. And they are on the desktop, okay? And it's now starting the download. It shouldn't actually take too long. And Microsoft on the back end basically looks into the APPX file, which is not more than a zip file. And it has all the executable, it has the manifest file and the resources in it, and analyzes it, and it will figure out that this is a 32-bit application with this version number. So everything got accepted at this point. So it's not the final certification. It's just they are accepting it. It looks technically all right. So next thing is just go again here and add a new package. You can actually upload APPX files with the same name. They will look into the package, into the APPX file, and figure if it's a different platform in there, then make it available as a second package. So open that one. Takes a second or two. And you see it's a little bit larger. It's 64-bit. And those executables are a little bit larger. And it's uploading and analyzing the whole thing in the back. And when it's done validating everything, you will notice that it's gonna be listed here as a secondary executable. And one thing is interesting to notice here, takes a second. Okay, so the blue one is offered to this device family first. That means if the user is running Windows 10 desktop, that's the main target that we are looking at. And if the user has a 64-bit computer, it will use this package. and offered if, and the yellow one is offered if a device can't support a higher ranked package. Yeah. So if you're running Windows 10 desktop on a 32-bit machine, it will take automatically the 32-bit package, which is an interesting system. So, and in the same way, you basically could add more packages targeting different platforms that they are offering here. So we are on Windows 10 desktop for now, and that's fine. So this is basically it. If you make any errors here, so you realize, oh, version number is different between those two packages, no problem. You can still remove the package here. And the advice is first remove everything that you don't want to have here, and then save the submission again, and then reopen it again. Because if you just remove and enter or upload a new package, the system easily gets confused here. So just save everything once you deleted what you did wrong, and then start the whole thing again. All right. So, well, we will roll out just immediately, and it's not really mandatory. You could set that. That means once the user starts the application, it basically gets a notification. Oh, there's a new version. Just update that. Okay, save that. And that takes another minute or so. And we are basically done now. Everything is on green. I didn't change anything else. I didn't change the store listings. Actually, we could go here and it will basically be good to write something what's new in this version. So we write something like a few UI optimizations, new app logo, make that a single line maybe, and that's it. So no changes here. And well, we probably should update the screenshot, so let's do that really quick. Okay, so just let's load the prepared screenshot that I just created here. That's on the desktop, and there's a screenshot, and add that one here. So we just need one screenshot. You don't have to put in all the other stuff here. And so we are basically done down here. So go to the submissions again. Whoops, 1 second. I have to click somewhere on save here. Where's the save button? Here. Here we go. And so our submission is now basically ready to be submitted to the store. And all right, so submit to the store. And this will put the application, the submission that we created, into a pre-processing process. And then this is automatically done. It only takes, I think, an hour or so. And then after that, it will go into the certification process, which appears to be halfway manually, automatically assisted, whatever. And that may take a day or so. So I assume tomorrow or the day after tomorrow, the application should be updated in the Microsoft Store. And we will see how that one works. All right, that's it for today. And I hope you enjoyed the video. And again, if you have any questions, just drop me an email at olaf@monian.net. Thank you.